News start tonight with breaking news out of Linden. One man rushed to the hospital following a drive-by shooting outside of a grocery store. A Columbus police officer was hurt responding to that crime. At this hour, investigators are still trying to piece it all together. Mary Smith is live on the scene for us tonight. And Mary, what have you been able to find out? Happening right now, a candlelight vigil being held in downtown Columbus to remember the young girl shot and killed by their own father last week. Let's take you live out to the pictures of that memorial right now. Tonight, the family and the community gathering to remember. Turning to the forecast now, Chief Meteorologist Marshall McPeak in with us this Saturday. And Marshall, you brought in the sunshine today. On New Tonight, a local business stepping up in a big way today to help families hit hard during the pandemic, giving away free food to ensure families don't go without. Now, this all went down this afternoon at the Safeway Mart. On New Tonight, a Columbus family with a special thank you this afternoon, getting a chance to meet the firefighters who possibly saved their lives face to face. Tonight, the family also has an important warning for others about what's often called the silent killer. Jesse Starkey has the story. All right, in the football fever, the Bucks and Bama set to clash inside Hard Rock Stadium on Monday night. A national title is on the line, and both teams say they are ready. The head coaches holding their final press conference today before the big game. Mr. 305 himself, Clay Hall, having a bit of fun as he works, of course, in sunny South Florida. All right, thank you, Clay. And, of course, this morning, OSU Athletic Director Gene Smith on Good Day Columbus talking about the excitement of the big game and the fight to even have this season. Developing right now, President Trump only has one more week in office, but Democrats are fighting to get him out right now. Faith Abube has the very latest from Washington.
Washington, D.C.
And following the violence this week in Washington, the president losing his most powerful tool to communicate with supporters, Twitter. Not only that, he's been basically kicked off of all of social media. Tonight, it's sparking questions about free speech. Mary Smith looking deeper into all of it tonight. Developing tonight, a deadly weekend across Columbus. Police investigating several different shootings. A number of those suspects still on the run tonight. A violent start to the new year. And in just about a week, the general population here in the state of Ohio will start to get that vaccine. Those 80 and up. Doctors stressing it's important to get them taken care of first. Jesse Starkey has that side of the story tonight.
Still a chance.
Hey, long as that offense is rolling. And speaking of the offense, coming off the game of his life in the Sugar Bowl, Justin Fields is hoping to end this wild season with a national title. Now, when he transferred from Georgia 2 years ago, he had a lot of pressure on his back to show and prove and get this Bucs team back to the mountaintop. And one thing's for sure, he has not disappointed. As Ohio State looks to make history, the 2014 Buckeye team knows what it's like to take on Alabama and win. Maria Durant talked to two of the key players from that team. Okay, Maria, what did they say about tonight's matchup? And developing at this hour, police in Upper Arlington investigating a pretty serious incident. Late last night, shots were fired into the home of the state's assistant medical director. Thankfully, no one was hurt. Tonight, investigators are trying to gather as much information as they can about a possible suspect and a motive. Mary Smith gathering the very latest for us tonight. Tonight, as numbers continue to rise across the country, the focus for the new administration is on fighting the virus and making sure more communities across the country can get that vaccine. Andrew Dimbert has the very latest. Happening tomorrow, the case against former President Trump moving forward in the Senate. This as he's set to deal with a new round of controversy. Rachel Scott breaking it all down tonight. It's an unthinkable pain that no parent would want to go through, the loss of a child. Tonight, Vanessa Kirkland dealing with the tragic deaths of both of her young daughters. She tells me she's doing all she can to remain strong tonight. Her family and many throughout the community have been a big support.
I'm here for a reason, I guess. I don't really know what it is, but I'll figure it out.
The emotions overflowing for Venetia Kirkland, imagining life without 9-year-old Ava and 6-year-old Elise Williams.
I feel lonely. Like, I have all my friends and my family, like, around me, but for the past 9 years, like, I had, like, my own family, and this weird, like, being out in places and not having them call me every 5 minutes asking me where I'm at and when I'm coming home.
Their beautiful smiles snatched in an instant. The two shot and killed by their own father, Aaron Williams, who took his own life soon after.
For the first few days after everything happened, you know, I would just lay around and stare at the wall and wonder if it was anything that I could have did to make stuff happen differently.
Kirkland says she could have never imagined something like this happening, saying Aaron Williams loved his daughters with all his heart.
Those girls was his world. Like, they was his everything. He did whatever he could to put a smile on their face.
As she works through the grief, giving thanks tonight for the outpouring of support the family has gotten from throughout the community, including Columbus Police, officers providing most of the funds for the funeral expenses.
I owe it to them to live and figure it out.
The funeral service for the two girls is taking place tonight. Saturday, the community is invited out to the vigil. It's taking place at 5 in the evening at the Scioto Mile in front of Coastside. We do plan to have a crew there, and we'll have an update tomorrow night at 6. Rodney Dunigan, ABC 6 News. Keep your eyes out and watch your surroundings. That's the word from police tonight. At this hour, officers working to track down the crooks out there looking for an easy victim tonight.
Take a close look at these snapshots. This crew caught on surveillance camera at the Kroger on South High Street in Columbus. Police say the two women you see right here offered an elderly woman a bit of help with her groceries. But instead of loading the items into her car, they ripped off her purse and took off, hopping into a car with three guys and speeding out. And this is not the only recent crime. A security guard at the Walmart on Morse Road sending us a message on Facebook warning women of other purse snatchings. The message from him: stay vigilant. If you see something, say something. The city of Westerville sending out a safety alert this afternoon following two recent purse snatchings, both happening in the Westerville Square parking lot. A few tips from police there: shop in pairs, park in a spot that's visible, and avoid distractions like talking on your cell phone when walking to your car.
The most important message from investigators tonight: if you know anything about this recent string of crimes, give police a call. Thankfully, at this point, we don't have any reports of anyone being hurt, but they do want to get this crew off the streets before that happens. Rodney Dunigan, 6 on your side. Okay, I'm going to be real with you. This could potentially be the last time you see me reporting in studio. Get this, I have my ticket, and if I were to win this time tomorrow, I plan to be on a sunny island somewhere. The jackpot tonight, $1 billion. Yes, billion with a B. The cash option, $739 million. Oh, what I could do with all that cash.
Get ready for another incredible Lifestyles, your VIP journey into the lives and loves of today's winners who really know how to enjoy the great things of life.
Oh, the great things of life you could enjoy for $1 billion. Oh, it just rolls right off the tongue so nicely.
Your host is Robin Leach.
Robin Leach would no doubt be impressed with what you could buy with all that cash. But let's just say your odds, yeah, not the best. Each Mega Millions ticket has about a 1 in 302 million chance of winning the big prize. According to the odds makers, you've got a better chance of being struck by lightning, becoming a Hollywood movie star,
and even an NBA player. That was always my dream anyway.
Until the winning numbers are revealed, we can all dream of what could be, at least for a.
And of course, we will have that drawing here tonight at 11. And just thinking ahead here, if I win, if for some reason I happen to lose, I'll tell you what, I got about 30 bucks in my pocket. I'll buy lunch for the winner. For community leaders, it's all about accountability. They say they understand the majority of officers do all they can to protect and serve the community, but they say those bad apples need to be picked out.
I think it's at a boiling point. I think we are just sick and tired of being sick and tired.
Michael Young, not holding back, the community activist and pastor of City of Grace Church, glad Columbus Mayor Andrew Ginther and city leadership are taking steps to make policy changes within the police department. But he stresses all the talk needs to lead to action.
I think rhetoric is one thing, but I think holding people responsible for their actions is something different.
He believes Andre's Law, introduced by City Council President Shannon Harden, is a good start. The legislation could lead to discipline for officers who don't give aid to those hurt by police or those officers who don't turn on their body cams.
I think this is an issue of humanity, treating everyone like they're a human being. You know, just to watch the video of Andre Hill, to watch how he suffered and took his last breath, it was deeply, deeply disturbing to see that they didn't treat that man as a human being.
And many of those community activists in Columbus, like Pastor Young, say they also plan to make sure that the mayor and other elected officials follow through on their commitments for meaningful change within the police department. Rodney Dunigan, ABC 6 News.